everyone. I hope that you're doing well. My name is Micah LeClercq, and this is my good friend Herb.
Can I go home now?
No, you cannot. Now, COVID-19 has pulled the rug out of under the entire world recently. And if you're watching this, it may be because you don't have a Sunday school to attend. Now, that is where me and my friends want to help. Tune in every Sunday, starting at 11 a.m., to watch us deliver a weekly devotional. But before we can get to today's lesson, we have to worship Jesus. And so to do that, we have our good friend. His name is AJ. He's going to do an action song for us. So everybody, stand up and worship Jesus with us as AJ does our action song. Take it away.
What are you complaining about? Have you ever tried jumping for Jesus in a pot?
No, I have not. But now that we've done our action song, it's now time for our scripture of the day. Herb, would you like to do the honors?
Oh, sure, Micah, sure. Let me just read the scripture with my eyes. Let me use my eyes to read the scripture.
Fine, then. I'll do it. Our scripture of the day comes from Matthew 22:37, KJV. It says, Jesus said unto him, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind.
Wait, who is Jesus talking to?
Well, Herb, someone asked Jesus that day what the greatest commandment was, and that was his answer. Let me ask you something, Herb. What do you do all day?
Sleep.
Besides that?
Take a nap?
No, besides that.
Go to bed.
No, those are all the same things. You can't just sleep all day.
Oh, I sure can.
What?
I'm so good at it, I can sleep with my eyes closed.
I thought you didn't have eyes.
It's a joke, Mr. Funny Boy. This guy.
The point is, God gives us all 24 hours in a day, and although we definitely need our sleep, we shouldn't devote all of our time to that. Some of that time needs to go to God, like praying or reading the Bible or writing Sunday school skits with a talking plant as the co-host.
Why?
Well, don't you love Jesus?
Of course I do.
Why do you love Jesus?
Well, because he loves me and he cares for me and he made me.
Okay. Well, wouldn't you want to show him how much you love him instead of just talking about it? Wouldn't you want to take some time out of your day to pray to him or to read his word? How about this? We will learn about someone in the Bible who had to learn to love God more than the one thing in the world that he loved more than anything. I have a friend who is going to go into our next segment, and he is going to teach us about Abraham and Abraham's ultimate test for his love for God. Take it away, Scooter.
Dun, dun, dun. He's going to teach us about the Lord. It's time for Scooter's Chalkboard.
Hey there, everybody. My name's Scooter, and welcome to my chalkboard. Now, I know what you kids are asking, what's a chalkboard? Well, I know all of y'all was raised on smart boards and whiteboards and skateboards and boogie boards and surfboards and board games.
Scooter!
But when I was a kid, and that was back in the late 1800s, I think, we didn't have all them. We had chalkboards, and today I'm going to teach you the good old-fashioned way. So today, we're learning about, what's his name?
Abraham.
Ham sandwich? Oh, yes, Micah, that sounds good. I'll take two and a glass of prune juice.
No, Scooter, not ham sandwich. Abraham. We're learning about Abraham.
Oh, yeah. But Micah, I need someone to do the voice of Abraham's son Isaac.
I'll do it. I want to help you, Mr. Scooter.
Whiff, don't do that to me. I'm old. You almost made me press my life alert.
Oh, I think you're okay. You fell down, but you got back up. I really want to help you, Mr. Scooter, and you smell like denture cream.
Fine. Just don't make me have another heart attack. I've already had two. And stop sniffing me.
Sorry.
Let's start. Abraham was the man that God called to be the father of God's chosen people. God even promised Abraham that he would have so many descendants that they would be like the stars in the sky. You wouldn't be able to count them.
Wow, Mr. Scooter, you're a really fast artist.
Why, thank you, Whiff. I've been told that I have the fastest chalk this side of the Mississippi. But my arthritis will kick in eventually. Anyway, even though Abraham was promised children, he didn't get a child for a long time.
How long?
100 years old long. It took a while, but God finally gave Abraham and his wife Sarah a son of their own when Abraham was 100 and Sarah was 90.
Wow, that's older than you, Mr. Scooter.
At least something is. I can't imagine having kids at my age. Grandkids are okay, but you can send them home when you run out of M&Ms. Anyway, Sarah and Abraham named their boy Isaac, which means laughter, because he made them laugh with joy. Abraham loved his gift from God with all of his heart. So much, in fact, he began to spend all of his time with his son, and not any time with God. So the Bible says that God wanted to test how much Abraham loved God.
Well, how did he do that?
Well, one day, God visited Abraham and told him, Abraham, I need you to sacrifice your son to me.
What do you mean by a sacrifice?
Well, back then, God needed you to kill an animal in order for him to forgive you of your sins. Nowadays, we don't have to do that anymore because Jesus died for our sins. But back then, Abraham did.
Right. He was gonna kill his son? God would never ask anyone to do that!
Well, he did, and it absolutely broke Abraham's heart. But he had to listen to God. He took Isaac aside and told him to get ready to go to the mountains so that they could sacrifice to God. But Abraham didn't tell Isaac that he was the sacrifice. On the way up there, Isaac asked, hey, Wyth, that's your cue.
Okay. Hey, Dad, can I lick these rocks?
Yes. No, no, that's not what Isaac asked.
Okay. Hey, Dad, can we go get a Happy Meal?
They didn't have Happy Meals back then. Isaac didn't ask any of that. He asked, Dad, I know we're going to sacrifice to God, and we have the fire and the wood, but where's the animal to sacrifice? Well, Abraham was on the verge of tears, but he replied, the Lord will provide.
Oh, no, 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 no. What's going on?
Eventually, they made it to the top of the mountain where the altar was. Isaac watched as his dad put the wood on the altar. Then Abraham turned around and said, I'm sorry, son, but the Lord has said for me to sacrifice you. Isaac let his father tie him up. He then laid him on the altar. Abraham raised his knife to...
No, 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 Mr. Scooter, you're scaring me. I know. Before he could sacrifice his son, a giant anvil fell on Abraham's head.
Exactly. A giant anvil fell on top of it. No, no, that's not it. That's not it. Abraham raised his knife to...
But then suddenly a giant triceratops rose out of the ground and ate Abraham!
Yes, a giant triceratops started to rise up... No, 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 you're messing me up. Besides, triceratops are herbivores.
Hey, look, Abraham's legs are being digested.
What am I doing? No, 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 that's not it, that's not it. Abraham raised his knife to...
But God came down and told him that all of this was a big misunderstanding.
Would you stop? Hey, actually, that's almost what happened. You're not all the way there, but Abraham was only obeying God. But then an angel of the Lord stopped him. He said, don't lay a hand on Isaac. You have now showed God that you would be willing to sacrifice your only son for him.
Whew, that was close. But what about the sacrifice?
Abraham turned around to see a ram with its horns caught in a bush. The Lord really did provide a sacrifice.
Hey, is this our Scooter's chalkboard? I was told to come here to play a sacrifice.
You're the sacrifice? But Mr. Scooter says it was a ram. You're not a truck.
No, 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 not that kind of ram. A goat ram, not a dog.
Hey, Scooter. 2 out of 10, dude. Good Lord.
Hey, come on, Herb. That wasn't very nice.
All right. Sorry.
Okay, so, Herb, this is the real question. What did you learn from today's lesson?
I learned that old Abraham probably didn't tell Sarah about his day. hey, honey, what'd you do today? Well, I almost sacrificed our son.
Well, I'm sure she would have understood if God told him to do it.
Yeah, that's true.
All right. But now, that's not what I mean, Herb. God was testing how much Abraham loved him. Do you remember what the most important commandment was from today's scripture?
Yes, it was to love God with all of our heart and soul and mind.
You're right. So, Herb, what if I said that I loved you, but I never spent any time with you or talked to you?
Then I would say you're fake.
Really?
Yep, faker than a plastic tree.
Well, that's pretty fake. Well, you'd be right. But then, if you love God, why don't you take some time out of your day to pray or read your Bible? That's how we spend time with God.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Well, Abraham was told to give up Isaac, his only son, the one thing he loved more than anything in the world. And God tested him, and Abraham passed. But if he was willing to sacrifice his son, what are you willing to give up for God?
Well,
the coronavirus has taken a lot out of our lives, but it has also given us some more time that we could spend with God.
Yeah, but I love sleeping and playing Sonic the Hedgehog and reading comic books.
And there's nothing wrong with that at all. But I'm not saying not to have fun. But we should devote more time to God. Maybe put down your phone or your Nintendo Switch or your comic book or whatever you like. Just maybe for an hour, just to pray with God some more.
As you say so.
And that concludes the first episode of the Puppet Pulpit Sunday School. Yes!
Finally.
All right. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. And please subscribe in order to get future episodes and to receive more songs and online lessons and even more fun videos here on the Puppet Pulpit. And also, remember to ask yourself, what would you give up for God? Yeah, yeah, you stay the same.